Hello, my name is Mark Fox, and I currently am the chairman of the Mandan, Hidatsa, and Arikara Nation. My father is Isaac Fox, and my mother is Virginia, and my grandfathers come from us, Frank Red Fox, Sr., and my grandma Gertrude Malnori. So those are my grandparents on my father's side. My Indian name is Ihukadiki Mazesh. And in Arikara, you know, it's Jiwatu, which basically means sage or sage man. And it's been my honor and my privilege to represent our tribe and be the chairman of the Mandan, Hidatsa, and Arikara Nation. My basic platform for why I would like people to reconsider continuing in this job or supporting me to continue in this job is I basically want to continue the progress that the tribe has made in the last 4 years. I want people to reconsider all the things that have been put into place, infrastructure, positive program development, a lot of things that we've worked on that I set out to do 4 years ago. We've been able to accomplish many of those things. And so we want people to look at those things and I want them to consider whether or not they think I can lead us into the future in the same positive way. And that's my hope and expectation. You know, over the last 4 years, we've had significant improvements in things from government reform, financial restructure, and also for creation of benefits that reach out to our people. But you know what? There's always more to do. There's always more things that we can get done. So we have needs. We have a great need to put more infrastructure into place. Health-related needs, for example, assisted living units that should be constructed and made available in each segment of our reservation. We have a need for housing infrastructure. We still are suffering badly from not having enough houses and infrastructure for people to place a home on. Our constituents, as members of our tribe, have the right to understand and know what's going on with our tribe. And that requires a number of things. One, of course, is preparing reports and documentation that shows what we're doing, in particular for our finances. But I feel very good that our council is now in support of showing our financials, showing our audit reports, and now we've begun the process of pushing that out to our membership. Transparency means people have an ability to understand what happens during our governmental process, our council meetings. So one of the things that we've done is have radio broadcasts, live radio broadcasts, online broadcasts, so people don't have to sit and wonder at home or wait outside to come into a council chambers or sit in the council chambers all day.